setting for our show. Now, as the sign says, it's a public amenity, meaning public toilet. All these people have been waiting for hours to get in, and it is the only amenity that they can afford to get into.
Say, Officer Lockstock, is this where you tell the audience about the water shortage?
What's that, little Sally?
You know, the water shortage. The hard times, the drought. A shortage so awful that private toilets eventually became unthinkable. A premise so absurd.
Whoa, there, little Sally, not all at once. They'll hear more about the water shortage, but in the next scene.
Oh, I guess you don't want to overload them with too much exposition, huh?
Everything in its time, little Sally. You're too young to understand it now, but nothing can kill a show like too much exposition.
How about bad subject matter? Or a bad title, even. That could kill a show pretty good.
Suffice it to say that in URINETOWN, the musical, everyone has to use public bathrooms in order to take care of their private business. That's the central conceit of the show. Better hope your pennies add up to the fee. We can't have you peeing for free. If you do, we'll catch you. We never fail, and we never bother. You'll learn that these public bathrooms are owned and operated by a private company. They keep admission high, generally. So, if you're down on your luck, you have to come to a place like this. One of the poorest, filthiest urinals in town.
And you can't just go in the bushes, either. There's laws against it.
That's right, little Sally. Harsh laws, too. And that's why little Sally here's counting her pennies. Isn't that right, little Sally?
I'm very close, officer. Only a few pennies away.
Aren't we all, little Sally? Aren't we all?
Excuse me, sir, but can you tell me the way to the private company which controls these public bathrooms?
You mean you're in good company?
That's the one.
You'll meet the guy who runs you're in good company later. That there's his daughter.
It's quite a ways from here, ma'am. You see, this is the bad part of town.
So it is.
But if you squint, you can just make out their headquarters rising above the skyline.
The gleaming tower on the hill?
Yeah, that's the one.
Gosh, it's beautiful.
You most certainly are. I mean, it most certainly is.
Oh, dear. I'm late already. Thanks ever so much for the directions and such. Bye.
Anytime.
Well, we've talked on long enough, I imagine. Enjoy the show, and welcome to URINETOWN, the musical.
It's a privilege to pee. Water's worth its weight in gold these days. No more bathrooms like in olden days. You come here and pay a fee for the privilege to pee. 20 years we've had the drought, and our reservoirs are all dried up. I take my baths now in a coffee cup. I boil what's left of it for tea. And it's a privilege to be. The politicians, in their wisdom, saw that there should be a law. The politicians taxed the toilets and made illegal public urination and defecation. So come and give your coins to me. Write your name here in the record book. The authorities will want to look if you've been regular with me, if you've paid the proper fee for the privilege to be.
Well, Miss Pennywise.
I said no buts, Bobby. You're a sweet-looking boy, and I likes to keep you around. But this man ain't coming in without paying. Not this time.
I can't wait much longer, Bobby. There's no telling what I might do.
You think you got some kind of right?
Kind of right, kind of right.
You think you come in here and go for free?
Free.
The only thing you'll get is no for free. I'm a business gal, you see. I sell the privilege to be. The good Lord made us, so we piss each day until we piss away. I'll charge you twice.
No need to jeopardize your position.
Or better yet, have you arrested?
I'm through with all this, you see.
Since you prefer the law gets tested.
Scrape and tash 3 times
and
a day.
URINETOWN, you'll see.
Crazy with a nitrous half the time.
Down to fight with me.
It's no way to live, I tell you. No way to live.
Life is unsustainable!
Well, that and the title's awful. Can't we do a happy musical next time?
Well, if there is a next time, I'm sure we can. Well, that's our story. Hope eventually joined her father in a manner not quite so gentle. Mr. McQueen opened a bottling factory just outside of Brasilia, which did rather well until the Amazon dried up and he moved. As for the people of this town, they did the best they could, but they were prepared for the world they inherited, weaned, as it were, on the legend born of their founding father's scare tactics. But when the water dried up, they recognized their town for the first time for what it really was, what it was always waiting to be. Good night!